placed two thermocol sticks perpendicular to each other, and on each stick I have pasted a scale. Pins have been attached at a unit distance from each other such that O is equal to 0.1, 0.1 is equal to 0.2, and so on. Here begins the process. We have to locate root 2 on horizontal number line. As you can see that triangle O, P1, P2 forms a right triangle such that O 0.1 is equal to P.1, 0.2. And hypotenuse O 0.2 represents root 2. For representing root 2 on this number line, we have to rotate this pin in a clockwise direction and fix it at this point. The point at which this pin intersects the horizontal scale represents root 2. In the same way, you can observe that O, P1, P2 forms a right triangle again, in which O, P3 represents root 5. For representing root 5 on this number line, we have to take it off, rotate this in an anti-clockwise direction again, and fix it on the horizontal line. The point at which the string stretches on the horizontal number line represent point 5, root 5. Again, in the same way, you can observe that O, P1, P4 is forming a right triangle in which the hypotenuse O, P4 represents root 10. For rotating root 10 on this number line, you have to take it off, again rotate it in a clockwise direction, place it at the point in which the string stretches, and naming the point A, point A is equal to root 10. At last, you can observe that O, P1, P5 again is a right triangle in which hypotenuse O, P5 is representing root 17. For representing root 17 on this number line, we have to take it off again, rotate it in a circular direction, like this. And the point at which the pin intersects the horizontal scale will represent root 17. Thus, we can conclude that in this particular way, we can represent various irrational numbers on a number line.